Hello friends, welcome back. I am Neha Padyani. In today's session, we will discuss about trial balance. So let's begin.
Problem on trial balance. This is the first problem that we are going to solve relating to trial balance. So in my previous session, we have already discussed the concept of trial balance. If you have not watched that video yet, I would request you to please go and watch that video, because there are certain points in it which we have already discussed and which are very important for solving the problem. Okay, link you can get in the description box below. So let's start with the problem. From the following balances extracted from the books of a trader, prepare trial balance as on 31st March 2015. So here we need to prepare a trial balance. The closing balances of all the ledger accounts is given to us. We just need to mention them in the trial balance and mention the amount in the debit or credit amounts columns. Okay, so this is the format of a trial balance. First of all, we need to write the heading. This is very important. Next is, this is the particulars column, also known as head or name of the account. This is ledger folio column, debit balances, debit amount column, and credit amount column. Okay, and when we were discussing the concept, we came to know that assets and expenses needs to be recorded on the debit side, and capital, liabilities and revenues needs to be recorded on the credit side. Okay, so this is very important. This you need to remember while solving the problem. Okay, so the first head is cash in hand, ₹4,200. So we know that cash is our asset, right? Remember, in trial balance, you need to know meaning of all these terms. Okay, until and unless you don't know their meaning, you won't be able to decide if they are our assets, liabilities, expenses or revenues. Okay, so first of all, try to know the meaning of this. So cash is our asset, right? Cash is our current asset. So this needs to be recorded on the debit side, because assets will be recorded on the debit side, right? So mention it. In the particulars column or head of the account, mention as cash in hand, amount in the debit amount column, ₹4,200. Okay, next, cash at bank. Again, cash at bank is also our asset, right? So this is an asset, ₹16,800. Again, mention it in the debit amount column. Cash at bank, amount is ₹16,800. Next, bills receivable. So bills receivable refers to the amount which we have to receive from our debtors. So when we are receiving, it becomes our asset, right? Amount is ₹18,000. So record it. Bills receivable, assets on the debit side, ₹18,000. Next, bills payable. Now this refers to the amount which we have to pay to our creditors. So it will be our liability, right? So this is a liability. Liabilities needs to be recorded on the credit side, right? So remember this. So record it. Bills payable, amount is ₹16,000 in the credit side. Next, sundry debtors. Debtors are our assets, so record them on the debit side. Amount is ₹24,600. Sundry debtors, ₹24,600. Okay, next, sundry creditors. Creditors are our liabilities. When debtors are our assets, creditors are our liabilities. Okay, amount is ₹32,400. Record it on the credit side. Sundry creditors, ₹32,400. Okay, next, capital. So capital also needs to be recorded on the credit side. Okay, so record it. capital on amount on credit side. Amount is rupees 50,000. Next, drawings. So drawings refers to the amount which is withdrawn by the owner from the business organization. So it is treated as expenses for the business organization because business has to pay certain amount to the owner in the form of drawings. Hence, drawings are treated as our expenses, right? Amount is rupees 18,000 and expenses are needed to be recorded on the debit side. Okay, so record it. Drawings. Amount rupees 18,000 on the debit side. Next, sales. So sales, when we sell certain goods to the customers, in return we receive certain amount, right? Certain money. So it will be treated as we have earned the revenue. So this is treated as our revenues. Sales are treated as our revenues, and revenues needs to be recorded on the credit side. Okay, so record it. Amount is rupees 1,05,000. Sales amount on the credit side rupees 1,05,000. Okay, next, purchases. So when we purchase certain goods, we have to pay certain cash, right? So it is treated as our expenses. So expenses needs to be recorded on the debit side. Rupees 75,000. Purchases on the debit side. Rupees 75,000. Okay, next. Carriage invert. So carriage invert refers to transportation cost. Suppose when we purchase certain goods from the shopkeepers, so we have to transport it to our place, right? From the shop to our place. So certain transportation will be required and we have to pay certain freight or fare for the transportation, right? So that we call it as carriage invert cost. So this is treated as our expenses. Okay, expenses needs to be recorded on the debit side. Carriage invert. Amount is rupees 2,700. Next, salaries. So business organization has to give salaries to its employees, right? So salaries are the expenses for the business, right? Amount is rupees 12,000. So record it on the debit side. Salaries, rupees 12,000 on the debit side. Okay, next, advertisement. So advertisement refers to the cost which is incurred for providing the advertisement. Okay, so this is also an expense. Amount is rupees 2,400. Because this is an expense, record it on the debit side. Advertisement, rupees 2,400 on debit side. Okay, next, insurance. So here, when we take the insurance policies, we have to pay certain premium to it, right? So paying the premium for the insurance will also be treated as an expenses. So to record it on the debit side, rupees 1,600. Insurance, rupees 1,600 on debit side. Next, furniture. So furniture is our asset, right? It is an asset to the business organization. So it is an asset, and asset needs to be recorded on the debit side. Amount is rupees 7,500. Furniture, rupees 7,500 on debit side. Okay, next, stock. Stock is also an asset, right? It is an current asset. So again, it is an asset. Rupees 18,600 on the debit side. Stock, rupees 18,600. Last, office rent. So paying the rent is treated as our expense, right? Rent is our expense because we have to pay it every month, right? So it is an expense. Again, expenses on the debit side, rupees 2,000. Office rent, rupees 2,000. So now recording is completed, right? Now we need to total both the sides. And in trial balance, when we total up the amount columns, they both should tally. Okay, it means that the both should get the same balance. If in case they get different balances, it means that our trial balance has certain mistakes. We need to correct them. So it is the rule that the balances should tally. So let's see if they tally or not. On debit side, when we total up all the amounts, we get amount rupees 2,03,400. So let's check if we get the same on credit side or not. 16,000 plus 32,400 plus 50,000 plus 1,05,000. So we have got the same amount, right? 2,03,400. It means that our trial balance is correct. We can write the total now. 2,03,400 on both the sides. Okay, so this was all about a problem on trial balance. Okay guys, so this was all about today. If you found this helpful, please hit the like button. Also subscribe to my channel. For any questions and queries, you can ask me in the comment section below. Hope to see you in my next video. Till that, happy learning.